Hello friends, Namaskar. In today's video, I am putting up before you answer to a very important question as to when a professional requires to get tax audited. Since the present is the tax audit season going on, so even the professionals should be careful about that whether a tax audit is applicable on them, and if it is applicable on them, when they can get themselves tax audited as per the requirement of law. Before I move further with my discussion on this particular topic, I am first putting up a question that who is a professional? A very important question. If I see its answer with respect to the definition of term profession given under Section 2 Clause 36 of Income Tax Act 1961, it says that profession includes vocation. Now, this kind of definition, which is so given in the law, can't be treated to be a definition. It is just inclusivity of the definition to say that the profession term includes vocation. That is a way of living life, that is the way of earning income. But we need to go into some in-depth understanding of what is a professional or what is a profession. And therefore, I put certain understanding in form of certain expression which are derived from certain case laws also. Profession implies professed attainment in a special knowledge as distinguished from mere skill. A profession therefore involves labor, skill, education and special knowledge and implies a vocation requiring higher education, learning or intellectual skill, etc. Meaning thereby that a person would be treated to be a professional when he is carrying out any activity with a special skill, with certain educational background or with certain special knowledge, etc., which may involve such usage of higher education which he has attained, such learnings or such intellectual skills at all. Now let me also put up one more angle under the income tax law, that the classification of profession from point of view of income tax law can be done on two sides. One, income tax law treats certain professions as specified professions and other professions as non-specified professions. The basic difference of such particular treatment by the income tax law is derived from section 44AA subsection 1, and this further ends up into section 44ADA, that is a presumptive taxation section, which says that in the case of specified professionals, they can opt for an easy regime of taxation to which we call presumptive taxation by offering minimum 50% or such higher amount which the professional thinks so as his or her income from the profession. So those which are specified professionals, they have the option to avail the benefit of 44ADA, and other professionals which are non-specified professionals don't have option to claim the benefit of this 50% regime under 44ADA. We also need to further give thrust upon this point as to how this distinguishment is important from tax audit point of view. So let's go further and see that particular discussion also. Now let me put up before you which are the specified professions or treated to be specified professional persons from the point of view of income tax law, just for the sake of a better understanding. As per Section 44AA of Income Tax Act 1961, following professions are treated as a specified profession. They are profession of accountancy, that is chartered accountant, legal profession, advocacy you may say, medical profession, that is doctors, engineers, then architectural profession, interior designers, technical consulting, and any other notified profession. Where from I derive this? The whole category is from Section 44AA subsection 1. Now the question comes that who is treated to be a notified professional? In this relation, I will further put up one more understanding before you. Mind you, my dear friends, these notified professions are notified by the CBDT, and they include information technology professions, they include company secretaries, they include authorized representative, and they include film artists. So these all categories which I discuss with you are basically the notified professions, and except these notified professions, all other professions are treated to be non-specified professions from the point of view of income tax law. Now I come to the moot question which I started at the beginning of my video, when a professional requires to be tax audited. To support my understanding, I put up before you Section 44AB, Clause B of Income Tax Act 1961, which says, every person carrying on profession. Now you see, it is not saying a specified profession. Every person carrying on profession shall. So it is mandatory. If his gross receipt in the profession exceed 50 lakh rupees in any previous year. So moment you are liable in terms of your gross receipt exceeding 50 lakh, you can be said to be liable to get tax audited from the point of view of Section 44AB of Income Tax Act 1961. Whether you are a specified professional or you are a non-specified professional, it doesn't affect the Income Tax Department. This is a very important takeaway point which we need to understand from this particular video. At last, my dear friends, I believe that this video would have been able to clarify as to which professionals, may it be they are specified professionals or non-specified professionals, are required to get audited under Section 44AB of Income Tax Act 1961. If you have any queries, you may write to me. I'll try to answer them. Thank you very much for being with me. Jai Hind.